In this video, I'm going to show you how to achieve the Harris Shatter effect using some strawberries and some sugar. The Harris Shatter effect is a colourful technique that allows you to create a kaleidoscope effect from moving subjects. Invented in the days of film photography by Robert Harris of Kodak, it involved exposing the same frame of film three times through red, green and blue filters whilst the camera remained still. The end result showed the static parts of the scene to look normal, but the moving elements were recorded in red, green and blue, creating a colourful effect. To achieve this digitally, it's a lot simpler. All you need to do is take three separate exposures and use a little Photoshop magic. It's a fun technique to use when shooting waterfalls, seascapes, smoke arts and even people on the go. But I'm going to show you how to achieve this effect by shooting some sugar granules to create a rainbow of colours over some strawberries. So let's get started. To create a dark backdrop, simply drape a piece of black material over a tall box. Next, place a tray in front to catch the falling sugar and place a bowl of strawberries on top. We now need to position a spoon in place above the strawberries for our main focal point. Get another box that is a couple of inches taller than the height of the bowl of strawberries and place to the side. Tape the silver spoon to the end of a wooden spoon to extend the length and then tape to the box like this. Now place your single strawberry on the spoon. Finally, fill a jug with some sugar for smooth pouring. Now it's time to set up the camera. It's vital that it remains in a fixed position, so place on a tripod and then position in a portrait format. Use Live View mode to help you compose and focus your shot. You want the tops of the strawberries to be at the bottom of the frame and the spoon and the single strawberry roughly in the middle, so there's plenty of room for the falling sugar at the top of the frame. The main focus point will be the single strawberry, so manually move the AF point and zoom in using the 5 or 10 times magnification button, switch to manual focus on your lens and adjust the focus ring until the strawberry is in sharp focus. We're going to light the scene with an external flash, so set the camera to manual mode and set a narrow aperture of f16 to maximise the depth of field. Set the shutter speed to the maximum flash sync speed, which is usually around 1/250th of a second, and then use the low ISO to minimise noise. To fire the external flash gun, we used our built-in pop-up flash as a transmitter with the camera acting as a master and the flash gun set to slave mode. Place a flash gun to the side of the setup. When using this method, it's important to make sure the flash's sensor communicates with the camera, as the signal between the two is optical, so it requires a clear line of sight to communicate. To set up the wireless control, press the menu button on your camera and navigate to the first shooting menu, scroll down to the flash control settings and press set. Ensure the flash firing is enabled and select the built-in flash function. Press set, then scroll down to the wireless function and press set again. Select the third option to trigger off the flash only. The flash control menu also allows you to select and control the flash power output on your external flash gun. Scroll to the external flash function settings and select the flash mode and set to manual power. I've set mine to half power. We can adjust this up or down to brighten or darken the image once we've taken a couple of test shots. Next, we're going to position a reflector opposite the flash, which will help to bounce light back into the scene for even lighting. Finally, if you have one, attach a shutter release to minimise any movement between exposures. Now with the scene set and the camera and flash in position, it's just a case of pouring the sugar over the strawberries. As you pour, start taking pictures and after each sequence of shots, check the preview on the back to ensure you've captured a balanced exposure. It's also worth rechecking the focus. With a good selection of shots in the bag, I now need to pick three so I can create the Harris Shatter effect in Photoshop. So once you've chosen the three images you want to use, what we're going to do is target the individual colour channels in each image. So starting with image number one, we're going to target the red channel. So what I'm going to do is add a solid colour adjustment layer, and in the RGB values down here, I'm going to enter 255 in the red channel, and I'm going to leave the green and blue at zero and then hit OK. What we're going to do is then change the blending mode to multiply, and as you can see, that's targeted the red channel. So we'll just flatten that image by going to layer, flatten image, and I'm going to do the same for these two images, but instead I'm going to be targeting the green channel and then the blue channel. So again, solid color, we're going to leave the red at zero,
the green at 255 and leave the blue at zero and hit OK. Again, go to your blending mode and set to multiply and flatten that. And then I'm just going to do the same for the final image to target the blue channels. I'm just going to pause the video quickly. So now that we've targeted each of the colour channels, as you can see in our photo bin, we have an image which represents the red, green and blue colour channels. And what we want to do now is combine them together. So what we need to do now is copy the blue and the green image into the red. So I'm simply going to hit Ctrl and A, so that's Command and A if you're on a Mac, to select all, Ctrl and C to copy, select our red image, and then Ctrl and V to paste. And then we'll just do the same with this image as well. And as you can see, if you look on the layers panel here, we've got each of these layers represented by each of the colour channels. And all you need to do now is simply set the blending mode in layer 2 and 1 to lighten. And as you can see, this has produced our colourful Harris shutter effect.